Hello, I'm Mr. Arniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. This golden temple is the same size as the holiest of holy that used to be in Jerusalem, and also the pool in which it is standing is the Bethesda pool of mercy that also used to be in Jerusalem. So Nanak or Christ, they are known only to the people of spirit, not to the men of letters. Even today I go to Oxford University and ask them, you know, you preach Christianity, do you know why Jesus is called Jesus? None of them has the answer, because one man said, Christ Church, you know, I went this Sunday, yesterday, and I asked the priest there, you know, pastor, do you know why Jesus is called Jesus? And he had no idea. Then I explained to him that Jesus in Hebrew name is Yeshua. Yah is Yahweh, Shua mean Adam, the firstborn of Yahweh, second Adam. So I will read some books, you know, to find it out. That means he was relying upon the letters, no spirit. Yes, that is what Jesus said, those who are drunk with the old wine of the letters, they can't take the new wine of spirit on top of it. So they are useless. I call them super donkeys carrying holy books, and they get annoyed. However, here I'm writing, have written a book on one God, one faith. And this is chapter, last chapter on 23, on predictions. These predictions you can easily make yourself if you understand the topic of religion. So its gospel is in your heart. It comes from your heart. It cannot be written down in ink on paper. So if you are well versed in the basic or logical reasoning that leads to gospel, logos, then gospel is in your heart, written over here, because you have done the logical reasoning. So you got it here, not in the book anymore. And our God Father is inside me. Because this is the temple of God, he lives here. He doesn't live in heaven anymore. So very many, many people don't know. They say prayer, our Father in heaven. I tell them, Father is living in your heart. Why you say blah, blah? He knows the things of your heart before you. It comes from at your mouth, but they don't believe it. You know, gospel is to those to whom it is given. Not everybody can have it. 1 in 1,000, 2 in 10,000. Let's do this predictions. Everything that happens in the world does so according to the will of God, our Father, our supernatural Father, and not to the designs of Satan. Therefore, a good grasp of the gospel in the capacity of the spirit of man, which is Holy Spirit, or common sense, called Surtti in Punjabi, can tell you all that is happening in the world and what should be, what we should expect to happen in the near future. So that is called Brahmagyani, that you understand what is happening and then you can tell what is going to happen. But gospel is to be received on individual basis. Nobody can give you. That's why Eucharist wine, you can't pour from one cup into the other. Catholic people, you know, I went to attend one of their annual meeting in near Reading, and I was dozing, sleeping. Then all of a sudden he said, you can't do this thing. You're It had to be served from one bottle. Ah, this is interesting. And later on I asked those priests, you know, why if you can't do it? He said, oh, in case you spill it. No idea. This is the cup. Nobody can give you gospel. Gospel received from our Father. Even Jesus could not give it to Peter. Presently, we are passing through Great Tribulations Period, GTP, which started in May 1948, when Israel was established in the fulfillment of Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30, that the tares would be bundled up at the end of the age and burned. The final burning or the atomic war is expected soon after Israel is 70 years old. During this GTP, there shall be many riots, both sectarian and non-sectarian, in which the tares and merciless people will kill and burn each other. In the East, the people will be very cruel, whilst in the West they would be sympathetic. Middle East will be between the two. In East, you know, in India, when partition took place, they were killing without any asking any question. The killing people, you know. In the Middle East, now they start killing those Christians and this Muslim, Mohammedans start killing them, you know. And now they say they are getting a undertaking from the Christian that they will obey the Islamic law and these things. So other way, they are sparing them. But not in India. Because India is the epicenter of the sons of Satan, emperors of Satan, and kings of darkness. Sorry, emperors of darkness. The criteria of destruction are laid down in the New Testament as well as Ad-Granth. It is much more explicit in the New Testament than in the Ad-Granth, Sahib of the Sikhs. In the New Testament, Jesus outlined in Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30, at that time, I will tell the harvesters, harvesters are angels, perfect in the moral laws. First collect the weeds, tie them up, tie them in bundles. That means in the country, you know, like in Israel, they are getting bundled up. Similarly, other places, you know, where the countries are getting destroyed, they are the weeds which are getting destroyed. Then gather the wheat and bring it into my barn. Wheat are those who are the sons of the Most High, and they will earn rest. And it is stressed again in Matthew 15, verse 13, but he answered and said, every plant, person, which my heavenly Father Yahweh hath not planted, everyone who shall forget his tribal integrity or tribal identity, shall be rooted up, shall be killed alongside his supporters. The same has been stressed by Christ Nanak. Bio bij pat lagai abkyo ugve dal. That is, those people who shall not forget their tribal seed will remain honorable. Or they will stay honorable. Nobody will dishonor them. This now many do not know why Jesus was named Jesus, called Yeshua in Hebrew. It is a compound name consisting of Yah equal to Yahweh and Shua or Shiva equal to Adam. Thus Jesus was the seed of Yahweh, the creator of creator demiurge god of male and female and nature at large, and Mary was his surrogate mother was Joseph of Judah tribe, his foster father. Jesus, being the second Adam, came as floating on earth with no place to rest his head, leaving no mark on earth, because the people born, which are, you know, have no tribal father, they have no right to occupy any part of the land. So he had no tribal father but Yahweh. So he came floating and left no place to rest his head. And he was buried in a newly built burial chamber. Chamber was newly built because every tribe has his own, our family has his own tribe burial chamber. But Jesus had no family link anywhere. So the burial chamber for Jesus was one which was not used by anyone at all. Again, a proof of the virgin birth of Jesus. Same way, the name of Nanak is hardly known to any Sikh. It is made up Na, mean no, and Nak, equal to the shame of the secular word. Nak stands for nose. That if you do something wrong, you know, which dishonor, you say, you got your nose cut. So, nose. In that, he did not obey his secular father, but he was solitary, pleasing our spiritual, supernatural father, Parbrahm, Allah, Elohim. So, he was solitary, you know, when they wanted to do the ritual of Janu and other things, he rejected. He said, no, 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 I don't want it. So, let's see how far we have gone. I will leave it here and do the other later on.